It's like an asylum. It's like a spooky building. Mueller Hall. Feet in the pond.
On your left, you can see the National Gallery of Victoria is an art museum located in Melbourne, Victoria, Australia. It is the oldest and most extensive public art museum in Australia and one of the most popular cultural institutions in the country. The NGV, or the National Gallery of Victoria, was founded in 1861 and opened to the public in 1862. It was established with the goal of bringing art and culture to the people of Victoria and has since become a significant cultural landmark in Melbourne. The NGV offers excellent facilities for visitors, including cafes, restaurants, and gift shops. The museum's architecture and design provide a modern and welcoming environment for art enthusiasts and visitors for all ages. The NGV offers free general admission to its permanent collection, allowing visitors to explore the museum's vast collection without a fee. Some special exhibitions may have an admission fee. The National Gallery of Victoria is a cultural gem that enriches Melbourne's art scene and offers an immersive experience into the world of art and creativity. Whether you're an art enthusiast or someone looking to explore and appreciate art, the NGV provides a captivating and enriching experience for all visitors.
Looks maroon at the bottom. Nah, the bottom looks dirty, you can see. Like silt or soft built up into it.
You can see the Art Centre Melbourne, located in Melbourne, Victoria, Australia, is a renowned performing arts and cultural complex. It is one of the largest and busiest art centres in the country and serves as a hub of various artistic disciplines.
We can see the thing, but it's
Correct.
The Art Centre Melbourne building itself is an architectural landmark. It's the iconic spire, known as the Spire, is a distinctive feature of Melbourne's skyline and is beautifully illuminated at night. Art Centre Melbourne plays a significant role in the cultural life of Melbourne, contributing to the city's reputation as a vibrant and diverse arts destination. Whether you're a performing arts enthusiast or simply looking to experience the richness of artistic expression, Art Centre Melbourne offers a plethora of exciting performances and events to captivating and inspiring audience of all ages.
Chafing. Oh.
We are now approaching the South Banks of Ulaid. An exciting setting offers ample shopping, dining, and entertainment choices for visitors, boosting some of the best restaurants in the city. A foodie's favorite and the ultimate dining destination, the South Bank Precinct has always been a top dining destination, known for its diverse restaurant choices and farm-to-fork cuisine. With so many options to choose from, you're certainly find something unique and appetizing at one of the South Bank's many restaurants. Come and find out for yourself why South Bank has been a dining paradise for Melbourneians. Explore the dining promenade at your own pace and enjoy something tasty for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. South Bank is literally packed with a wide array of restaurants serving all types of cuisines. You'll find a number of cafes, restaurants, tapa bars, pubs, and alfresco dining venues here. South Bank restaurants indeed offer a smorgasbord of different cuisines, including traditional fares to delicious sushi. Whether you're looking for a fine dining venue or delicious pub meal, you're sure to find everything right here. No matter what you choose, you certainly have an unforgettable dining experience as the sun sets, South Bank glitters with the lights of the nearby pulsating bars and pubs. The variety and splendid options of bars and pubs make it a perfect destination for all visitors and locals to drink, dine, and enjoy the night. The scenic Yarra River on your right runs through some of the prime suburbs in Melbourne, beginning from its source in the Yarra Ranges and then flowing 242 kilometers west through the Yarra Valley, before it opens out into plants as it winds its way through the greater Melbourne before emptying into Hobson's Bay. The banks of the Yarra River boast some of Melbourne's most famous attractions, such as the Royal Botanic Garden, Melbourne Park, South Bank, Federation Square, and many other top attractions. No wonder Melbourneians often regard the Yarra River as the social heart of the city. The Yarra River is definitely a famous icon of the city, with popular events like Moomba, the Melbourne Festival, Dragon Boat Festival, and rowing regattas held on the Yarra. Along the scenic banks of the Yarra River, you'll come across a multitude of quaint and scenic settings. There are excellent barbecue spots, jetties, fishing platforms, and picnic areas. Additionally, there are some excellent walking and cycling trails along the banks of the river.
Restaurant we ate at was Robert, but I think it's right up there. I think anyway.
This is pretty green, isn't it?
No, this is Mum Lounge. care on the other blocks. It's like level 2 and 3, it's suddenly kind of like just up from the bottom. Down near the first pillar, just on the water side there. Here or the next one, I'll just forget my framing. Maybe the next one. This one.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I don't know if there's lifeguard or not, but. Hopefully they turn these lights down.
I think that's
the easiest
one.
Okay, we walk down. Number one doesn't work. We did the same thing before that was going to go off. No, well, it's like a whole bunch of stuff I've read too. Thank you.
get to meet Maxim walking through the convention centre.
Jordan Peterson isn't here. So that's going down to South Wharf over there.
Yeah.
And this is a hotel up there. Sounds like the flame's going off, but I think that's just a tram. I think it's sealed, I don't think it's holes in it. It's not like an old pier. So there's the hotel up there. Okay, so I don't think I've actually stayed in the city that many times in my life. I can probably recall maybe one other time, and it was maybe someone's bucks night or something. I stayed in the city. Josh Ramona, whose wedding it was. Like, I've been to Matt's Bucks in the City, but I can't remember where we went, if we stayed in the city or if we went home. Wonder what classy piano music's going to be playing in the foyer. There's the World Trade Center area. Surprised no one's tumbling here. Not sure why there's a door here. Oh, that's just a tram. It sounds like the flames are going off again. Okay, that's the valet parking there. Our room is up the top there somewhere. Okay, we'll come back to you from the top again. Okay, we've gone up the escalator again. Is that a screen or a fake fire? What's that? It's a TV screen. So this goes from the lobby area to the guest rooms. Little feet, very sore.
Lesson learned.
Now which one's going to go off?
For the sake of the...
Oh, it's that one again. Okay, have to turn off. You're going to see Dynamo's eyes.
So, that's it guys. That's our anniversary celebration dito sa Melbourne, dito sa city guys. Nakita nyo ang ating walking tour, sa ating room tour pala, sa ating Crown Plaza dito sa Melbourne. And then nakita nyo ang Yarra Valley, nakita nyo ang wharf, ang casino.
Yeah, the Yarra Valley, the bit of a fire show, the room tour, the time-lapse of the drive-in. It's a fair bit here. We also walked up and down a bit of St Kilda Road. So yeah, you'll be able to sort of see what the city, or at least the South Bank area, is like at night time. We didn't venture like into the CBD as such, but yeah, we kind of went up and down here. So we're staying at Crown Plaza, which is kind of like right on the edge of the CBD. You can have the camera outside, but you probably get reflection. So the exhibition center is there, and that's kind of like nearly the start of South Wharf. So that's kind of like the start of the next area to the right.
Yeah,
but South Bank's pretty much all the way to the left there.
Yeah, that's the exhibition of Melbourne.
Yeah.
And then this is the Crown. This is the famous casino here in Melbourne, guys. Dito sa Victoria.
Yeah, so we entered the casino pretty much all the way down there somewhere. And we ended up walking down all the way down. And we actually exited out of the taxi rank down the bottom there.
Yeah, so there's a lot of people there. As long as you in a legal age, you can go inside the casino.
Yeah,
it's
so we entered at the... Well, I took some video of the fountain and the steps. Like, that's kind of like the entrance up one end of the casino, and we walked all the way through. We had a couple of drinks, we played some of the machines, and then we exited out this end here.
Yeah.
So I think there is like another level inside. You can go up an escalator, and that takes up to another casino floor, but it's just more poker machines. So there's not too much more you're missing out on there. But it kind of spans about two city blocks of the casino itself, because it goes, we're on Spencer Street now, and then I think there's King Street. And then I'm not sure if it goes all the way to Queen Street as well, but yeah, it goes out two city blocks from where we are now. Yeah. So
our hotel, because Jax booked this hotel and then he put something that our anniversary. So they give
what
us
a Managanong anniversario.
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 So we have the what's the name of the wine?
It says Ate Shiraz.
Ate Shiraz. So
I mean, on the side it says Ate, but I'm gonna say it's Ate.
Yeah, so we will drink this one, guys, because we just get back from the Crown guys in casino. So this is a complimentary drink from the Crown Plaza. So Megalop shout out.
Yes, thank you, Crown Plaza. It's the first freebie I didn't even ask for a freebie. All I said on my booking form was, it is our anniversary. Could you decorate the room or something? Like, I thought maybe I'd put some rose petals on the bed or something. Like, I thought they might do like a love heart with a towel or some rose petals on the bed. But yeah, we got wine, so yeah. Like I said, it's the first time I've actually like mentioned it. And yeah, I got it there. Also, I think when I booked dinner, I requested an outside seat, and we did get kind of like the balcony seat there as well, so we could see down to South Bank as well. So we've got another half an hour into the next fire show, so we're gonna drink our wine. I don't have to drive anywhere, which is good, because usually after we go for dinner on a Friday night, I always have to drive home after we drink our wine. So yeah, we're just gonna chill out here for the next half hour, catch the next fire show, and yeah, we're still exhausted from skiing, and we did drive, 3.5 hours back from Bright today?
Yeah, and then
plus another hour. Oh, we were only home for about an hour and a half, and then I had to drive another hour to get into here from Lilydale, so a lot of driving. A lot of walking here as well. We're still tired from all the skiing. So yeah, we look forward to the weekend and being able to recover from it all. It's like we need like another holiday from a holiday. So
bulaga guys, this is the end of our anniversary for today's video. I hope you enjoy watching, you learned something today, plus you had fun for today's video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for supporting our videos, and magalaw shout out to these wonderful, beautiful people of the universe. Thank you from the bottom of my hypothalamus. Please like if you did enjoy my video for today.
Yes!
And please subscribe if you haven't yet.
Yes!
And for you to hit the bell button for you to get notified on my next video.
Yes!
And please comment down below if you like this video.
Yes!
See you when I see you on our next one. Bye bye, guys. Be good. You take care. Be safe. And ma. Ciao.